Welcome to Brain Thunder, where we interview millennial entrepreneurs, scientists, commentators, and everything in between, people that make a difference in their industry, here to inspire and educate. With us today, we have Dakota Smith, a Beam community champion, Beam being the charity that gets people off the streets and into sustainable jobs training. Dakota, after working with Beam, is now an author, a blogger, and a social worker, as well as someone that has started her own brand and her own business. Dakota's story personally inspires me. I'm proud to call her my friend, and I'm very much looking forward to talking to her today about how she completely turned her life around. Dakota, welcome.
Thank you so much for agreeing to do this. I am so, so thankful. First of all, I'm an avid reader of your blog. It's very, very vulnerable. It's very touching. It's very to the point. And I love when people are unashamedly who they are, because that takes a lot of courage. And in my eyes, vulnerability is strength and always will be. And to me, you exemplify this perfectly. So I want to know a little more about your story and a little more about how, I guess, life was when you moved to the UK in 2013, right?
Yes.
How was life then?
To be honest, it was a bit of a challenge because I wasn't working at the time. I felt like I was stuck because I couldn't really do some of the things that I wanted to do, but I knew one day I would have been able to. So it was challenging for me. But after that, after everything was sorted out for me and I was able to pick up the pieces little by little, then I was able to start all over. In my head, I was like, you know what if people should see me? Mm-hmm. And then, you know, I thought, I don't even care if people want to see me. It's just that I'm going to get the help. And it's a step, because I wouldn't be able to afford going to college at that time. So getting someone to really help. And I thought, you know, I'm going to go for it. The company, which was Beam. And, you know, I was like, you know.
And I want to talk about Beam. I love Beam. I have been a longtime supporter of Beam. And yes. I'll tell you what really bugs me. What really bugs me is when people tell me that charities don't help and they don't do great work and organizations like Beam just don't make an impact in people's lives. And I understand there's sometimes some skepticism when it comes to specifically the extent to which those charities help. And for example, the extent to which the donations that are being made are being redirected to help people that have potential like yourself. And I get that, but Beam is so different, as both you and I know. It's one of those charities and organizations that truly, truly help people from disadvantaged communities and give them a leg up and give them the training that they need. And I think you're such an exemplary model of how great Beam works and how amazing they are and the whole team is. And I know them and I love them a lot, that I thought I should share this with the world. So how did you find out about Beam?
I'm basically classified as homeless because people who are in private rented properties are more likely to become homeless than someone who is in council properties. I remembered when I was there, and that's when we had SHP. So they were closely with Beam. We've got these people who, as long as they fit the criteria, then we'd be able to pass them on to you guys. Yeah. And I remember having my advisor from Beam. She was fantastic. I went in, we did CV. She met me at the college. We did from in the morning until late afternoon. If I still need help, I would be able to contact them for, you know, advice or anything like that. But
yeah, no, they're very helpful. And they definitely maintain their relationships. I think that what's really special about them is that, going back to how a lot of people feel that their contributions don't make a difference, and obviously you're the prime example that they do, but Beam is very different in that whoever works with Beam, they will send you a full-on detailed breakdown of exactly how much is being directed towards Dakota's education and Dakota's travel and Dakota's equipment and her materials to study and be an amazing social worker and help people, because she has the empathy of knowing what it is to be in hard circumstances, of understanding the pain that you can't teach And so that's the one of the main reasons why I work with Beam, being one of the charities I work with, because I love them and I love how it's run by millennials. It's run by people that help mostly millennials. It's an incredible, incredible charity. And look at where you are now. I mean, you're a single mother. You have your own brand. You're an author of your book. I remember when I met you a couple of years ago, you told me about a book you're writing, and I want to know more about your book.
Yes, so I started writing and I thought, you know what, I think I should share about my story and about my life, and I know it will actually help someone else, because I think sometimes a lot of us, we have too much pride. Let's say we need help and we know I have too much pride, I'm not going to seek help. So I wanted to share my story, let people know, like, growing up, yes, and I would probably say I struggled a bit, or my family, I didn't come from a wealthy background. This was, I just wanted to write about my whole life, things I've been through, and just to encourage someone, to let them know that there's light at the end of the tunnel.
Have you picked a title for your book yet?
Yes, it's called The Strength of a Broken Woman.
When is it coming out? When are you thinking
of it? To be honest, it's with an editor. Okay. So I'm doing like self-publish, and then...
I would read that book. Thank you. I told you, I'm an avid reader of your blog. So for me, I would jump straight into that. I love this.
I'm just taking time.
Yeah, no, absolutely. You've spoken about your faith quite publicly, and this is something that I fully resonate with, being someone that is very in touch with my faith. How has God and how has faith helped repurpose your life, and how has it really empowered you through this journey?
For me, I never let go of God. Even when I'm going through rough times, I still hold on and hold on to his promises. I always try to stay positive. That's why I try not to have people around me that are negative, because I don't want them to mess up my mood, even when things are not going right.
Yeah.
And I do my affirmation here before we did anything. I had this. So it's like, God hears
me. God hears you.
I've got these inspirational books. Sometimes, you know what, I don't know what to pray. I go down on my knees. I just say, Lord, thank you. Sometimes all I do is to play music. And then I say, God, I give back all this worship to you. So
I love worship songs as well.
Yes. So the thing that I do is to just stay prayed up, trust God, because you know what? He will never leave us nor forsake us. His promises are always, you know, and they're yes and amen. So at the end of the day, I try my best just to stay as positive as possible, stay prayed up, and just to continue to trust him. And it's been working. So
working. Exactly. That's why I love talking to you about those things, really. You started your own business. I got a message and I followed your new business and I'm very excited. Is it a fragrance? Thank you.
It's a fragrance business. Yes. So it's called Scententize Fragrance. So they do like designer inspired fragrances. Mm-hmm. And to be honest, it smells just the same, but they last up to 8 to 12 hours, maybe. Mm-hmm. All I need is like honest reviews from even customers. Yeah. I just want the honesty.
Genuine reviews. Yeah.
Yeah. So I remember I started it last year during the pandemic. To be honest, it's going, you know, looking for people to join the team, but it's going. And I thought for me, I've always wanted to do my own scent.
Yeah.
So that's actually in the pipeline. It works. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exciting.
So I'm just trying to
balance everything and being a single mother to me is incredible. Yes. It takes a lot of work and it takes a lot of persistence. And I want to finish with this. You're someone that has, in my view, completely beat the odds and truly got out of a situation. I mean, you were homeless. It was a hard situation. And now you're someone that has their own brand, their own business, you know, writing a book, being a single mother, a woman of God. And I adore every single one of those things about you. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of people right now that are homeless and they don't know that they will see the other side and they don't know that there's anyone that can help them. What advice would you give them as someone that has persisted and has got out the other side, so to speak? What advice would you give to those people that are now where you used to be?
if you genuinely need the help and you want to get out on the other side, all you have to do is to just take away some of that pride or put it aside a little, ask for help. It's either yes or no. Mm-hmm. Continue trusting God. Always associate yourselves with other people who have already made it, or people who you can learn from. We need people around us who's going to push us to become better. So I would basically say, just continue trusting God. Hold on, work hard, and just ask for help. It's either yes or no.
I love this. My mom always says to me, you know, you miss 100% of the chances you don't take. And if yes. you don't ask, it's a no anyway. So why not ask yes. and be done with it? Thank you so much. I know we said it's going to be a quick chat. It's been 20 minutes. Thank you so much for coming. I really appreciate you. I think you're an inspiring entrepreneur and someone that has beat the odds. And so I think more people should hear about your story. And thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Virtually.
Thanks for having me. I know.
I can't wait to see you in person soon.
Definitely.
I'll give you a big hug and we'll hug it out.
All right. Thank you, Martha.
So much love. Thank you so much, my love.
Okay, have a good day. Bye.
You too. Bye. It's that new age, ain't it something special? Yeah. We gon' change the game. We gon' live.